On April 23rd, at 3 o'clock p.m., Rim released Minecraft Speedrunner vs. 5 Hunters, and this boat clutch made me think that his videos are fake. But before I made a video on it to milk as many views as possible, I wanted to hear Dream's thoughts and the pinned comment on the Extra Scenes video so that he will release an uncut version and an analysis. So, I waited. My name is Shrifter, and I hope you all enjoy. Now, before I get into the bold clutch, I'm actually going to talk about why I've never had this suspicion in the past. And Dream's Manhunt videos do seem fake because a lot of people say that he does insane clutches, right? A lot of people say that he always gets villages and desert temples off the start, but there is a rule in Manhunt which states that if you dream kill early, then you actually restart the whole run. So, all the times where they punch him to death at the start, or he misses a clutch, or he's stuck in the middle of a snow biome, you don't see those times. Now, that might seem kind of weird, but basically, that's why he does certain things, because he knows that if he fails, he can just restart. But also, if they kill him off the start, they do get some money, an undisclosed amount, and so they still have an incentive to kill him off the start. Another thing that I see frequently is people accusing the hunters of being stupid. Like in this clip, where he has half a heart and there are four of them. Like, why not go in? Well, Dream has gotten much better at 1.9 PvP since the Techno Duel, and he can easily 2v1 and even 3v1 if Sapnap isn't there. So you have to consider that 1, they don't actually know what his health is, and 2, he has an iron chestplate and a shield, so he actually outweighs them in this matchup. But it is still better to go in. I'm pretty sure that 4 people can still beat him even if he has a shield, but considering that they don't want to lose their progress, and manhunts are around 3 to 4 hours, they have plenty of time, so they would rather not choose this fight. Alright, so now that I've gotten some misconceptions out of the way, let's talk about the boat clutch, shall we? Alright, so when I first saw this clip, I was thinking that there was no way that a human is able to think that fast. I thought that there was no chance that Dream could, while falling, think that there's a crafting table, he has to drift towards it, access it, get his wood from this slot, craft a boat, shift click it, and then land and hit an MLG boat at that speed. And that's not even talking about how fast the craft was. I was sure that it was faked. Dream was in the air for 153 frames of a 60fps video, which means that he was in the air for 2.5 seconds. Now that's not fully accurate, it's possible that the recording software didn't catch every single frame. It might be up or down by 16 milliseconds or so, but I genuinely just do not believe that it's possible at all. But still, I waited for the uncut version, and while I was watching the uncut version at 25% speed, I noticed that he didn't actually have to think that fast. Dream is not an idiot, and he was on the tower for almost 2 minutes smelting food and looking at his inventory. He has stone, food, tools, and wood. Now, tools and food aren't helpful at all. The stone, well, he would have been able to jump down and block clutch, but he had no health after Sapnap hit him. So, he has wood. Well, he's really far up in the sky with no water around to be able to jump to. So, literally, the only thing he can do is MLG boat. So, I'm sure he was thinking of MLG boating. And we're able to see that he already thought of MLG boating before he fell. Because he put on leather boots at this moment in order to leave an empty slot. Also, Dream is using a custom server jar and a custom mod, which means that Dream had 32 frames to craft this boat. Now in vanilla Minecraft, from the same momentum, you have 10 frames to craft it. Now, I'm no astrophysicist, but I know that 320% more time isn't a little more time. And on April 27th, Dream did an analysis stream, and before I end the video, these are his thoughts.
Right now, and then I realized, like, as soon as I break it, I was like, oh god, I didn't make a boat yet. Right? I'm like, okay, I didn't make a boat. So I'm thinking in my head, right now, I'm like, okay, I don't have time to, if I place right now, I'm not going to have time to, if I place right now, I'm not going to have time to get my furnaces. If I place right now, I'm not gonna have time to craft a boat, then break my furnaces, and then jump off. So I was thinking, okay, well, I need to break my furnaces and then place a crafting table and craft the boat. So I'm thinking through, I'm realizing I'm going to have no time. I'm going to have literally no time to craft a boat. So there's a couple things I do. One, you see in my hotbar, I have leather boots in my 5 slot. So at some point I put them on by right clicking on them because I realized I need an empty slot, but I realized I need to do it after I break the furnaces. Cause if I break the furnaces, they'll go into my hotbar. So this is all before, this is before the actual craft. So I was realizing now, okay, I need to clear up that slot. So that's why afterwards I end up putting the leather boots on before I craft. But anyway, so I'm realizing, okay, reaction time is a big problem. So I knew where my wood was, and I knew, okay, my wood's like right next to my, cause whenever you open your inventory, your cursor spawns like defaultly in the middle of your inventory. Obviously I know that. And the funny thing is from experience is I used to, when I played on MCPVP, which is a soup PVP server back in the day, you had to craft like mushroom soup really quickly. And so always you would always put your bowls and your two mushrooms in the same place where this wood is, where the wood is on this boat clutch. You would always have them in the exact same place. And sometimes you would need to craft mushroom stew really quickly because you're getting crit out, you know, and you need to craft soup and soup heals you in MCPVP. So like, obviously that's kind of like very, very, very like muscle memory, like back to like when I was playing in 2011 to 2015 of really quickly being able to grab that. But anyway, I realized, okay, I'm not going to have like any time in order to do it. So I'm like, okay, I need to prepare. And so what ends up happening is I'm like, okay, I need to break these furnaces. So I'm breaking. They took so much longer than I thought they would, but I put the boots on. So now my inventory slot's cleared up. I goes, okay, I put the boots on. I placed the crafting bench. Oh, I placed a crafting bench. Okay, well, I'm going back. I placed a crafting bench in order to craft the boat. So the thing is, like, it's not this clutch would be absolutely, it would be impossible, 100% impossible, if I hadn't already thought about crafting the boat, because you just don't have reaction time. Like, it's just impossible. Like, it's like half a second. Like, almost nobody has that fast reaction time, like, in the entire world, and like, including me. So it's not like if I had not already been thinking, okay, I need to craft the boat, I need to craft it super quickly, then I'd be dead. I would have, there's no chance I would have gotten it. I wasn't sitting there in midair going, I'm going to craft a boat, I'm going to fling my cursor out my woods here. No, I had already thought of all that stuff. So all I had to do was just do it. And then obviously a lot of luck comes into play, and just literally like flinging your cursor. Like, literally just the only thing that I think that wasn't luck was just being able to grab the wood that quickly, because I feel like that's just kind of muscle memory. But like, the actual boat craft was just me flinging my cursor, and I was holding shift the entire time. I just pressed shift, flung my cursor, and held down click and then spam clicked after, and that's how it was crafted. Now I would never, like, there'd be like, this is like a one in a thousand probably play where if I did this 1,000 times right now, I'd probably be able to do it once from the exact same scenario. But yeah, so, and then the quick boat craft and then the clutch. It didn't even really hit me like how quickly I had crafted it at this point. It didn't really hit me until like afterwards when I was watching it. Cause the funny thing is, like, I was sitting in a call with Sapnap, like in the morning before the manhunt was coming out. I had just finished editing the video, and I was watching it back, and I was like, oh my God. And I was sitting with him. I was like, I literally was saying, it looks fake. I was like, it literally looks fake. And it's like, oh yeah. Cause it's just, you're not used to seeing like